Battle Sport is a really unique game. No, you know what? It's not a really unique game. It's a really weird game. I mean, it's like an arena shooter, a first-person shooter in an arena where you control these spaceships, these UFOs that fly low to the ground. But it's actually a sports game. You don't really have to shoot. I mean, obviously it helps. But the whole point of the game is to collect these futuristic floating balls and shoot them into this goalpost in the middle of the ring. You do this by flying your ship towards the balls and then try to avoid the enemy. If they shoot you too many times, they can make you lose the ball, or of course they can just destroy your ship. But I've noticed destroying your ship or destroying the enemy ship doesn't really affect you much. I mean, obviously you lose the ball, but you seem to have infinite lives. The whole point of the game is really to rack up your score by getting as many balls into the goal as possible. So really, it's a sports game where you can choose to have futuristic arena-style battleship combat, but you really don't have to, unless the enemy you're playing against is really good. You wouldn't think a weird game like this, with a completely strange, unique concept, would be good, but the game is surprisingly good, and even more surprising how addicting it is. It's really fun to play. The AI isn't the best, but it's also not stupid, so you get a good challenge. There are other challenging things in the game. For instance, sometimes the actual goalpost, the place where you have to shoot the ball into, it's not just low to the ground, it's actually floating above you, so you have to press the L1 and R1 buttons to jump up and then shoot. This makes actually scoring points in the game way harder. Pretty much almost impossible. You'll be lucky if you're gonna score one or two goals for the entire game. Another thing that makes the game more challenging is it feels like you're sliding. Like, this isn't so much a futuristic soccer game as it is a futuristic hockey game. The sliding works for a game of this type, though. You could tell this was done on purpose. This isn't sliding where it's hampering the actual gameplay, like Color Dreams games, 2D platforming games for the Nintendo. They were famous for having sliding in their platforming, so you'll jump from platform to platform and then you'll slide right off the platform because you're going a little too fast. It was really annoying in 2D platforming. Here it kind of works. It gives the game a new dimension, a new challenge that you need to overcome. It's just fun. I don't know how the sliding works, though. I mean, you're not like on ice, you're, from what it looks like, flying spaceships or some kind of futuristic floating cars low to the ground, so I don't know why there would be sliding. I'm not a rocket engineer. If you're a rocket engineer, please explain to me why these things are sliding. There's also a good variety in the type of UFOs or ships that you can actually play with, and they all have different stats. The thing is, some of the stats aren't that important. Like, going really fast, not important in this game. It might help the actual CPUs because it'll be hard for me to shoot them because of the speed they're going at, but even the slowest ships in this game go plenty enough for like a regular real player. Combine that with the fact that the ball is moving around, sliding, you're constantly sliding, it's hard to line yourself up with the bowl and also the goalpost to begin with. Being able to go like super fast is not a good thing. In this game, it's kind of a handicap. It's really unnecessary, especially since you have the shooting function. I mean, you don't need to escape the enemy. You can shoot them with either powerful missiles or just the regular barrage of lasers, which takes longer, but these are a lot better. The powerful missiles that you shoot with the X button, it's hard to actually, again, line up the shot. But the automatic lasers that just perpetually shoot a stream of gunfire at the enemy, these might miss, but they keep going and going, so they're gonna hit the enemy a little bit here and there. This is the primary weapon here. Using those powerful missiles, kind of a waste of time, unless the enemy is like right in front of you and barely moving. Addicting and surprisingly fun. You would think a game like this wouldn't be fun. You would think the best a game like this could do is like mediocre, but this is just good. But Stan, you ask me! I can hear you. I'm watching you. All the people right now watching this review, I can hear and see you through the webcams and cameras on your phone and on your computer. I'm big brothering all of my fans. I can see you asking, Stan, how does it compare to other games of this type? And to them I say, what other games of this type? This is not a type. Futuristic space UFO hockey, this isn't a genre. But to be fair, there are games kind of like this that I've reviewed in the past, so let's compare and contrast a few. Most of these games will just be space combat. First game, Metalhead for the 32X. This is a game I reviewed something like 3 years ago. It's basically a game where you play robot in first person perspective, walking around the city, shooting things, shooting other robots with different kinds of weapons. The robot didn't handle as well as the ships in this game. It's more or less from the same era, but Metalhead was on the 32X. And this is a PlayStation 1 game. Well, really, this is a 3DO game that was later ported to the PlayStation 1. But ultimately, I think the graphics are slightly better in Metalhead. And also, I think it's just a lot easier to show off your graphics when you have this whole city to create versus just this one octagon or square arena that doesn't have a lot of content. It's just a couple of pillars, maybe some graphics on the actual walls of the arena. There's like a planet floating out into in the distance. It's hard to show off your graphics when you're working with just one small arena versus one giant city. But where I had more fun, this game, without a doubt. That game was a lot slower, and the combat wasn't as good. The combat here, because of how well the ships control, even though they are on ice, it's just a lot more fun, and this game is very addictive. Like, I can't see myself going back and playing Metalhead, and I haven't. I reviewed that game years ago, and I'm not going back to play Metalhead. It's just something I forgot about. This game, I mean, I'll probably forget about it, but this game goes down smooth. It's like a nice warm cup of tea when it's raining outside. It's not like an amazing game that you're gonna tell your grandkids about, but it's something you'll have fun playing when you get a chance to play it. So overall, I think this game is better than Metalhead. Although Metalhead had a way cooler name. I mean, Battle Sport? What is that? That's so generic. That could be anything. That sounds like some kind of futuristic B movie from the 80s, starring Jean-Claude Van Damme's cousin, Steven Claude Van Damme, who can't kick as well. He can only punch. He's a boxer by trade. He does these cool boxing moves, and everyone's like, all right. Well, punching isn't that impressive as spinning sidekicks. Anyone can punch. Metalhead sounds like some kind of robot porno, which is awesome. Now, if I were to compare it to your typical space shooters, I've reviewed a couple. Let's take two I reviewed. One is called Shadow Squadron, the other Star Wars Arcade. These games are so similar, I'll just like compare this game to both of them at the same time, like they're identical twins, even though there are slight differences. First of all, I think this game controls a lot better. Maybe it's just because there's not like a 3D dimensional plane where you can fly left, right, up, down, left, up, left, right, left, down. You can fly anywhere in space. In this game, you can only go in a circle. Like you can't fly down, you can't fly up, you can only jump up once in a while. So even though there's a lot less places to go in this game, the controls are a lot better. In terms of the combat, in those games you got to destroy these giant ships, but it was a lot harder combat. In this game, you're shooting like an opponent, one opponent, where the AI isn't that impressive in terms of them shooting you back. In those games, there's ships flying all around you, so it was just a lot harder. I think the combat, while being more fun in this game, it was more challenging in those games. In terms of ultimately where I had more fun, honestly, I'm gonna stick with this game. Battle Sport is better than Shadow Squadron and Star Wars Arcade, ultimately. It's a much smaller playing field. I mean, in those games, obviously, there's an end to the map, but you're flying in space, there's a lot of different enemies at once. And this game isn't purely combat. Like I said, it's also this futuristic space hockey. But I like the combat in this game a lot better, and also the addition of the sports aspects makes the game even more better on top of that, because I do like the competitive nature of this game. It doesn't take itself as seriously as space war combat in space where your life is on the line. In this game, like, even when you die, you don't really die, you just reappear, which means, like, I guess nobody's sitting in these floating UFOs. I guess you're just controlling them from far away with a remote control or something. I don't know. Ultimately, yeah, this game beats all three of the games I compared it to, so I guess it must be really good, in my eyes at least. Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more classic game reviews. Goodbye, my friends.